it's 5 unit part B. This extract is taken from Gerald Durrell's book, My Family and Other Animals, when Durrell was young, his family lived in a villa on the Greek island of Corfu. This was a time of bliss for him, for he didn't go to school but roamed about the countryside at will. He befriended the many creatures he came across and wrote of his experiences with a touch of humor. He used to run a zoo in the Jersey Island, having brought animals from all over the world. This chapter, dear students, this chapter is about the some insects or small creatures, reptiles, etc. They are living in the wall, and the writer is a child who is roaming around. His school is off, so he is moving around, and he's free, and he breaks the wall and sees the reptiles and this kind of animals. So first of all, the chapter is the word in a wall. We will do the word meanings. So as you can see on the screen, first is intricate. Intricate means very complicated, which is very complex, not simple. Then is self-effacing, modest, and not which cannot draw attention to. That means the person who is not able to draw the attention of others. Weird looking. This is weird looking means something strange in appearance, something different in appearance. And next is bulbous. That means round, bulb shaped. Round shape, which is somewhat coming outside. And the next is unassuming, means shy, the person or the animal who is shy. Blue bottles, that means a kind of flies. It's a kind of flies. Let's come to the next one. Impeccable. The word is impeccable, that means well mannered or the perfect. Well-mannered or perfect. Fawn, fawn means light brown color. In enraptured, that means delighted or very happy. Manoeuvred, that means it's pronounced manoeuvred. That means move very carefully. And the next is dawdling, doing something slowly, taking more time. Doing something very slowly, which takes more time. Superstitiously, that means, this is surreptitiously, means secretly, when we do something very secretly. Oblivious, totally unaware, when you are not aware of any situation. And impending, used to describe an event, or usually which is unpleasant, that means which is not very happy, you can say some sad event. Glibly, taking fluently and easily. Hoisted means raise something. When you raise something, that is called hoisting, like hoisting the flag when you are raising it. Scuttled, that means run hurriedly, quickly. And next is confetti, small pieces of colored paper which we used in the cell. When like there is a birthday or any celebration at home or somewhere else, we use the colored paper and sparkles, etc. That is called confetti. And the next one is bewildered. That means very confused, very puzzled. Next is chaos. Chaos is a situation of when one person is very much confused what to do and what not to do. Like when the things are scattered and you don't know what to do. Pandemonium, that means wild and noisy. When there is a very much noise and you are very much confused what's going on and what to do, that is the situation of pandemonium. Mystified, that means utterly perplexed. Mystified means also some mystery and getting confused, this kind of thing. Imploring, that means begging, beg something from others, ask something from others, this is called begging. Impatient means passionate. Impatient means when we are very passionate about something, we want something very dearly, we are fond of something, that is called. Slaughtered means killed. And quashed, that means rejected, not allowed, the thing which is not allowed, this is called quashed. and the last few words are left. Now prudent, that is wise. The person who is wise is called prudent. Siesta. Siesta means when you are taking a nap, means little bit of sleep for some minutes or half an hour or so. That is afternoon. In the afternoon when you get lazy and lie on the bed and have some sleep. But for a few minutes. Phobia, when you are afraid of something. Some people are having phobia of water. Some are having phobia of going to hills and any kind of phobia it can be. That is fear. And next is repercussion. That is result of an event or action. When an event happens and that is the result of one. So what you have to do today, you have to write the difficult words in your notebook. And today I would send you the question answers of the answers of the last chapter. So you have to make sure to write in the notebook. That I would send you in the homework. Now let's start with the chapter reading. The crumbling wall that surrounded the sunken garden alongside the house was a rich hunting ground for me. It was an ancient brick wall that had been plastered over, but now this outer skin was green with moss, bulging and sagging with the damp of many winters. The whole surface was an intricate map of cracks, some several inches wide, others as fine as hairs. So the crumbling wall means the wall that is about to break. It has got very weak. It means crumbling. That surrounded the sunken garden. Okay. The child goes to the garden and the wall is sinking. You can see in the picture. The wall is sunken and it's broken. I think you are all of you are able to see and understand this line. So that surrounded the sunken garden alongside the house. Along the house there is a garden, and there is a wall which is broken. Was a rich hunting ground for me. The child is saying it was a rich hunting ground. Means he usually goes there. He enjoys there. He sees the insects and all these things. This is for a place hunting. Is he is very fond of. He usually goes whenever he is free. Now the schools are off. Child is free, so he often goes there. It was an ancient brick wall that had been plastered over. As you can see in the picture also, the bricks are of ancient kind, and it has been plastered. Plaster, you know, that means cemented. But now this outer skin was green with moss, as you can see in the picture. This is green with the moss. You can see the green portion is there. And that means the wall is very old. And due to rain or due to water, there is a green part over that. Okay. But now this outer skin was green with moss, bulging and sagging with the damp of many winters. That is... bulge means coming out and somewhat bent of because of winters. The whole surface was an intricate map of cracks, and some several inches wide, others as fine as hairs. What had happened, you can see the cracks in the picture, and the whole surface an intricate map means it was a like a complicated map. In which you are not able to understand anything, and some several inches. It was a wide, several inches, as you can see in the picture. Others as fine, like it's very thin, like hair-like structure on that. In the first paragraph, the author is saying there is a wall which is broken, and there is a garden around that where the child often goes in the morning. And as you can see in the picture, it's playing with the reptiles and little animals. He's very fond of. And the wall is broken. It's green. You can see in the picture, it's green on the side because of the rain or because of the winter. And the water is continuously coming on that. This is the reason. And the wall is plastered. There are cracks on the wall. You can see in the picture. And it's like a complicated map. So coming to the next paragraph, the inhabitants of the wall were a mixed lot, and that they were divided into day and night workers, the hunters and the hunted. Inhabitants of the wall means the little creatures which are living. Inhabitants means the creatures or the people living, which are living. Of the wall were mixed, that means there were some, many kinds of animals, and they were divided into day and night workers, the hunters and hunted. Okay, that means you can see some animals or creatures appear in the day, and some animals and creatures they appear at night. So they are the mixed ones. And hunters and hunted means some animals eat the others, those are hunters, and which are eaten, those are called hunted. But that means this paragraph is telling that there are mixed kind of animals or reptiles. It will be explained later in the chapter. So they are visible. Some are visible at in the day and some are visible at night. But the shyest and most self-effacing of the wall community were the most dangerous. You hardly ever saw one unless you looked for it. But the most shy animals and or the most modest, we don't want to draw attention, we don't want to be seen. The wall community means the which are living in the wall or around the wall. These were the most dangerous. You hardly ever saw one unless you looked for it. And yet there must have been several hundred living in the cracks of the wall. Okay. The author is explaining there are several kinds of animals living here, and these are some appear during the day, some appear during the night. They don't want to be seen, but they are very dangerous. They can be the most dangerous of all, and there can be if you want to see them very clearly, or you just chase them, you can see they can be hundreds living in the cracks of the wall. That means in the crack of the wall, they make place for themselves, and even they can be very, very dangerous, and they can be hundred in number. So slide of a knife blade carefully under a piece of loose plaster and lever it gently away from the brick, and there crouching beneath it would be a little black scorpion an inch long. Now, what does the child do? He takes a blade, he makes a hole, some place so that he can see inside under a piece of loose plaster. Means the, there was a, when sometimes due to rain or due to winter or some other reasons, the plaster means the outermost covering of the wall gets loose, as you can see in the picture also. So what does the child do? With the help of blade, he carefully breaks the plaster and gently away from it, somewhat away from the brick, it can see, and he bends close to the ground, and beneath it means below it, you can see would be a little black. What does the child see? See in the picture, you can see there is a scorpion. So the child is seeing the scorpion. It's a black color. It comes out of the wall. It's of the black color, and there crouching beneath it would be a little black scorpion, and it was, what was its length? An inch long, looking as though we were made out of he were made out of polished chocolate. Okay, its color is like you can say brown, just like a chocolate. So it looks as if it's polished. Okay, they were weird looking things with their flattened oval bodies, their neat crooked legs. So its color was brown, and it was coming out of the brick, and it was like looking like a chocolate, and the body was flattened, oval shape, means shape like egg. Their neat crooked legs, the legs were very neat, the enormous crab like claws. It had the claws, the lower part of the limb, you can say, of the animal, and it was just like a crab, and bulbous and neatly joined as armor. It was it had the appearance of just like round, and its neatly jointed as armor, and it was like the legs were looking behind, and the tail like a string of brown beads. How did the tail look? It looked like the brown colored beads, and ending in a string like a rose thorn. Okay, now in this, the appearance of the scorpion is told. Its tail ended like a rose thorn. That means there are thorns at the end of the string. Okay. Now let's. I would repeat again this paragraph. The boy goes outside near the wall and takes the blade. And what he does? Puts some. You can say some place near the plaster, and there comes a scorpion. Now the child is bending down on the earth, on the ground, you can see, and there is a scorpion. It's of brown color. It has oval shape. Its legs are like crab, and its shape is like it's moving like bulges, means coming out and round. And its color is chocolate brown, and its tail is ending like in brown color, you can say it's stinky. Means the part is which is it's like bead, and with the thorns. That means it can also be very dangerous. Now moving on to the next line, the scorpion would be there. Sorry, lie there quietly as you examine him, only raising his tail. The scorpion would lie there quietly as you examined him, only raising his tail in almost apologetic gesture of warning if you breathe too hard on him. Okay. Now the scorpion is lying on the ground, and it is very quiet. There is no movement. Only the movement is behind from the tail. That means if you are breathing very speedily, so that might be afraid, because these are actually sorry, these animals are very shy, and when they feel that someone is coming near or seeing them, they disappear. So it's also like that. Gesture of warning means it's warning that you should not touch, or you should not breathe upon, otherwise that would disappear. If you kept him in the sun too long, he would simply turn his back on you and walk away, and then slide slowly but firmly under another section of plaster. Okay. The author is saying if there is a sunlight and you put the scorpion outside during the sun, and it takes you too long, then what would it do? It would turn back, means it would turn behind and walk away. Where it would go, and then it would slide. That means quietly get inside. Actually, these animals or reptiles require a very small space to get inside the wall, but firmly under another section of plaster. That means if you are putting a scorpion for a long time in the sunlight, it would run away and slide away somewhere inside the wall. Section of plaster means wherever it gets space, it would run under the wall. I agree. In this paragraph, the author wants to say this animal is very shy. Okay, and if you want to put some more time it outside in the sun, it would definitely run away. I grew very fond of these scorpions. I found them to be pleasant creatures with, on the whole, the most charming habits, provided you did nothing silly or clumsy. Okay. Now the child is saying, the author is saying, he is very fond of these scorpions. They are very pleasant and very shy creatures on the whole, totally. And the most, they are having the most charming habits. Charming habits, which means that which attract the people. These are the charming habits. Provided you did nothing silly or clumsy, they are charming until you haven't done something very clumsy. Means you don't put your hand on that, otherwise they would run away. The scorpions treated you with respect. Their one desire being to get away and hide as quickly as possible. They must have found me rather a trial. So what had happened? Means if you don't touch them, you treat them with respect. And what is their desire? Means they only want to come outside they want to run away because they are very shy and they don't want to be seen. They must have found me rather a trial. Means they might have found me like a trial, for I was always ripping sections of the plaster away so that I could wash them. So what the author is saying, he was removing the section so that he's capturing them and making them walk in jam jars so that I could see the way their feet move. Now what does the author do when the scorpion is there? He gets away inside the wall. He gets inside and he could see the way their feet move. He wants to see how the scorpion is moving, the way he gets moved. In this paragraph, what does the author want to say? The scorpions are very shy. They don't want to remain in the sunlight for more time. If you touch them by mistake, they would run away. They don't want to be touched. They move in the wall inside. If they feel that someone is coming near, someone is observing, they want to run away. They don't want to be appear. But they can be dangerous. That means they can be very poisonous. So you should be very much careful about dealing with them. Next paragraph is, by means of my sudden and unexpected assaults on the wall, I discovered quite a bit about the scorpion. Okay. That means assault means basically when you attack someone. So the child has suddenly opened the wall. The animals were lying inside and they were not aware that someone is coming near them. So what do they do? They come outside and what does the author discover about it? They are coming about outside the wall and he says that he had come to know something about that. I found that they would eat blue bottles. Though how they caught them was a mystery, I never saw. Okay. Grasshoppers, moths, and lacewing flies. Now, what is the observation of the author? The author's observation is that they would eat the blue bottles, means they would eat the flies. But the author doesn't know when did the fly came and how did he catch the fly. It's a mystery. And there are grasshoppers, moths, and lacewings. Several times, what is the author finding in the wall? Grasshoppers, moths, lacewing flies. Several times I find them eating each other. A habit I found most distressing in a creature otherwise so impeccable. What does the author find now? He found them eating the moths and the flies eating each other. What was distressing? But means what was the thing which made the author surprised or somewhat upset? That interesting in a creature otherwise so impeccable. The creatures were very much perfect, but the thing he found was this thing he found that this was something very strange, that he was they were eating the insects. And one day I found a fat female scorpion in the wall wearing what at first glance appeared to be a pale horn or coat. One day, what does the author found? A fat female scorpion in the wall wearing white, what of at first glance appeared to be a pale phone. Okay, see the picture. Students, you can see on the screen also. The scorpion was female. It was very fat, and it was it appeared to wear brown colored dress or phone, you can say, phone colored dress. Closer inspection would prove that this strange garment was made up of a mass of tiny babies clinging to the mother's back. These are the tiny babies on the mother scorpion, you can say. So when the author looks closely, what he finds that these are the babies, tiny babies clinging on the back. In this paragraph, the author is saying the child has seen a female scorpion, and what does he see? That there is a female scorpion. It's very fat, and but the babies are clinging to its back. So that is the, and it appears that there's a brown colored cloth on it. Now next line, I enraptured the mother and family into a matchbox. By this family, I made up my mind to smuggle them into the house and up to my bedroom, so that I might keep them and watch them grow up. What the author makes up the mind to grab the family. He wants to take into the house and up to the bedroom, so that he can keep them. He wants to see them growing up, and so that he can keep them and watch them grow up with infinite care. I maneuvered the mother and family into a matchbox and then hurried to the villa. It was rather unfortunate that just as I entered the door, lunch should be served. Okay. Now, what does the author do? He takes the scorpion family, the mother and babies, etc., in the matchbox very carefully. Why very carefully? Because these creatures are very small and very difficult to handle. Because as you touch, and they run away, and even that there is a danger of biting also. So very carefully he puts them in the matchbox. He makes up the mind to take them away to the bedroom. Why? Because he wants to see them growing up. And when he reaches home inside the house, what does he find? That the lunch is about to be served. When he opens the door, that means why he is saying unfortunate? Because everyone is sitting on the dining table, as you can see the picture. Can see the on the dining table, everyone is sitting at the dining table. And why it's dangerous? Because he wants there is a danger of seeing. He doesn't want anyone to see. However, I place the matchbox carefully on the mantelpiece in the drawing room, so that the scorpions should get plenty of air, and made my way to the dining room and joined for the meal, dawdling over my food. Okay, in this paragraph, what does the author say? I place the matchbox carefully in the mantelpiece. Okay, the mantelpiece is it's kind of a shelf in the drawing room. In the drawing room, there is a shelf. So he puts them on the mantelpiece in the drawing room, so that the scorpions should get plenty of air. Why does he put on the mantelpiece? So that the scorpion family can is able to breathe, and it can have plenty of air. And after putting them on the shelf in the matchbox, he goes to the dining hall. dining room and join the family for the meal. That means he joins the family to take the meal. Dawdling over my food, feeding Roger and surreptitiously under the table and listening to the family argument. Okay, now he joins the family and he sits on the chair and feeding Roger means you can see there is a dog in the picture. He starts feeding him and he secretly sees under the table and listening to the family arguing. What does he means? Maybe the people of the family are not aware that he has come. So listening to the family. What does he listen? He listens to family arguing. I completely forgot about my exciting new VHS. So the family was arguing on some issue, and then he forgot about the creatures and captures me the creatures he had captured. At last, Larry, having finished, picked up the matchbox he had brought. At last, what happened when his family member Larry, he has finished and picked up the matchbox he had brought. Because he was not aware of the things kept in the matchbox. Oblivious of my impending doom, I watched him interestedly as still talking glibly. And he opened the matchbox. Larry was not aware about the things in the matchbox. So what did he do? He opened the matchbox. And he was not, the person was not aware, but the author was not aware. He was involved in talking. So he was totally unaware. He very slowly opened the matchbox. Then what happened? Now he maintained to this day that the female scorpion meant no harm. So what excuse does he give? Now the family members come to know that there is a scorpion family in that. So he makes the excuse that I maintain to this day that the female scorpion meant to no harm, that the female scorpion doesn't harm anyone. She was agitated and trifle annoyed at being shut up in a matchbox for so long, and so she seized that first opportunity to escape. Okay, the female scorpion was irritated. Annoyed means getting irritated, getting angry to be kept in the matchbox for so long, and as it got the opportunity, it got out of the this box. She hoisted herself out of the box with great rapidity, her babies clinging on desperately, and scuttled onto the back of Larry's hand. What did the scorpion female do? It came out as it was irritated because it was kept in the matchbox. So as it got the opportunity, it came out of the matchbox and it came on the back of Larry's hand.